Tune in for .NET Conf on September 12th. Save the date. Learn everything you want to know about .NET platform, building for the cloud, and artificial intelligence. We have tons of speakers from around the world, 6 continents represented, win prizes at a virtual attendee party. Don't want to miss this. www.dotnetconf.net. Save the date.
Hey, welcome to another episode of the On.NET Show. Today, we're going to get a sneak peek of .NET Conf 2018 with Beth.
Hey.
Awesome. I think we did this about a year ago.
We did, actually. It's,
okay.
Yeah, we're doing it again in September, so
right.
That's why I'm back.
Yeah. Right. So we're doing .NET Conf again.
So, yeah.
What year is this?
So this is 28. Oh, the year that I've done this?
Yes.
Oh, God. So I kind of inherited .NET Conf when I came into marketing.
Yeah.
4 years ago?
Okay.
3 years ago? Three. I think this is my third one. But
yeah.
.NET Conf has a long history, actually.
Right.
It was ASP.NET Conf
yeah.
before that.
We should figure out when the anniversary date is at some point.
I think it was 2007, actually. It's
okay.
Kind of going on as a small community thing, and it just kind of grew bigger and bigger and bigger kind of over the years.
Okay.
So, yeah.
So on that note, how about you tell us how it is getting bigger? Like, do you have any numbers on...
Yeah. So, well, last year we had, over the course of the 3 days, live views and on-demand views, we had about 250,000 viewers.
Nice.
So views. So this year we're trying to go big or go home and make it even bigger and better. So last year we also had like 71 worldwide events going on at the same time, watch parties and local events that were happening. And this year, this morning, we just hit 101. So,
wow.
Yeah, so 30 more than last year. And like
and
we still have 26 days to go.
Right.
Right.
So people can still sign up.
Yeah, they can still sign up. And
okay.
And yeah, we'll advertise them on our website, and so people can kind of go and register for these sites. Or basically, like, here's the map, and pick where you want to go, and you can either watch it on September 12th. It starts the 12th, it goes the 13th and 14th, and a lot of these user groups are doing 13th, 14th watch parties. But they also go all the way to the end of October, so some of them will be, presentations, hackathons, workshops, all kinds of stuff. So,
I see.
So our local events are, we're sponsoring them and helping them. You know, we send them a little bit of swag and thank yous. We've got some partners that are going to try and help out as well. So yeah, that's kind of like the local piece to this.
Awesome.
But the big deal is obviously the live stream. Okay, so. Everything happens here and on Channel 9, and we're syndicating across some of our partner sites as well. But this is the conference kind of at a glance. Our first day is the keynote. We're going to have Miguel de Casa, Scott Hunter, and Mads Torgensen doing everything you want to know about what's new with .NET.
Right, the classic .NET
yep.
people.
Yep, they did the keynote last year as well, so they're going to be doing it again this year. And then we'll kind of kick it off with Scott Hanselman and John Galloway. We'll come out for about a half an hour, and they'll talk about the status of health of the community, our ecosystem, our open source projects, and that kind of stuff.
Love that stuff.
And then we'll just broadcast sessions. We got some great sessions from Microsoft the first day.
And that's kind of what we've done in the past, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we'll bring in our first day is really around application frameworks and developer tools. So we'll do a lot of Xamarin, we'll do ASP.NET, we'll do Visual Studio, productivity, things like that. C#, what's new and what's coming in C#, the language. And then in the second day, we're going to kind of focus a little bit more on Azure and AI. Okay, so we'll have a lot of sessions on cloud development as well as kind of what you can do as a .NET developer in machine learning and artificial intelligence. So that's kind of like the theme of the second day. After the second day kind of ends at 5 o'clock and we kind of sign off from the studio, we're going to be then broadcasting on Twitch and Mixer. We have a Visual Studio channel on those platforms, and we're going to go all the way around the world in local time zones. We have 6 continents represented. Our community will be presenting and we'll be pulling an all-nighter back here in Studio C. managing that. And
lots of beer and pizza.
Yeah, so it turns out, last year, if you tuned in, we had two streams concurrently going.
Right,
we had
I
two studios
that.
Running at the same time, and you picked a channel. We ended up with 45 sessions total over the 3 days.
That's a bit like the Olympics.
Yeah, it is, actually. it's really true. But also, we kind of wanted to try a new experiment this year. We're still going to end up with 42 sessions because we're going to do this 24 hours. And we kind of wanted to experiment with the new platforms on Twitch and Mixer.
Yeah, so, I hear those are popular.
Yeah, so there's Scott Hunter, welcome. The C Sharp is coming up right after that, so Mads will take off with what's coming. We've got Glenn with ASP.NET Core. Kendra will do Visual Studio for us. James Montemagno, obviously, he's the mobile guy. He's going to show us all awesome mobile stuff. And then we've got, the attendee party that happens after day one. So there's a virtual attendee party. I know, like a conference, right? Like you have an attendee party, right? So we wanted to do an attendee party. Another experiment, but...
So this one doesn't involve rides at Disneyland.
No, it doesn't involve rides or, a concert or, all that. Obviously, it's virtual, but we have sponsors, our partners, our Visual Studio partners, and our... hosting this, and they're gonna send out trivia questions to the audience. So you just basically watch the hashtag .NETConf. Richard Campbell will kind of host it, and you answer questions and you get entered to win prizes. And so our sponsors will be giving Xbox or a laptop or whatever. Yeah, so you can
awesome.
Win some prizes. So that'll be kind of fun. So we'll be out here managing Twitter and Twitch. We'll actually do it on Twitch as well, so we'll have some video content as well on the party. So day two, then we'll kick it off with ML.NET. We'll have some fun announcements around that. And then Caesar will kind of dive in a little bit on AI for every .NET developer.
Yeah, because I think AI, it's like everyone has this idea of what it is, but doesn't really see necessarily a path to how to use it in a real application.
Right.
So maybe that's what he'll explain.
Yeah, he's gonna kind of give us more of a whirlwind of all the different services you can use in Azure, as well as all the way to building custom custom code with ML.NET to do more deeper kind of analysis and things. And he'll show us he has an end-to-end example based on that eShop on containers, the Docker kind of example that he's been building. He has one for that shows how to build out AI ML into your apps. And it's not just about web applications. He's going to show bot framework, and he's going to show some cool stuff. So that'll be fun. Andrew and Paul, I think this one will be really interesting. We've been just talking about it, hey, these are the five Azure services everybody should know. And they kind of did a small version of this, a short version of this, 20-minute version at Build at a theater. They have an hour now, and really what we want to show is hey, it's not about building new applications. You might have an existing application that you want to kind of get into the cloud so that you can maybe slowly phase migrate it into something else. Maybe you want to move to .NET Core, but you can't right now, but you want to take advantage of some cognitive services
right.
or Cosmos DB.
How do you get some value right away?
How do you get some value right away? And so they're going to show you how to take your WCF service or ASP.NET website and get it into an app service. And then they're going to show you five services that you can use as you start to migrate and cloudify your application.
Right. So, sounds like super practical.
It's very practical.
Guidance.
If you know Paul and Andrew, they're actually pretty practical dudes. So I think that's going to be a pretty good one. And then obviously we have microservices development. We're going to show Azure Dev Spaces, which is really just a way to really easily build and test microservices when you're on a distributed teams and different services with different languages and that kind of stuff. And then what we'll do is we'll end up switching right at 5 o'clock local time, Redmond time, okay?
PST.
PST. We'll switch over to Troy Hunt. He's in Australia. And I've never met him personally, but I think a lot of our community knows him fairly well. So he's going to talk about literally how he has scaled, built, deployed, and have run a website at scale on a coffee budget, basically. So very interesting architecture he's going to walk us through. So
absolutely.
Yeah. So that will kick us off, and then we'll keep going. We have six continents, I think, represented here. So we're going to pull an all-nighter you know, here, and we'll go all the way around the world. So some of the other, like Mete Amel from Google will be speaking as well.
Nice.
Yeah, we'll have Ed Thompson. He's over in at Cambridge, so he'll be showing us some cool stuff with VSTS. So it's a mix of community and Microsoft speakers on this feed. Philip Carter with F Sharp. Myra's interesting. She's going to actually speak half an hour English, and then she's going to do half an hour of Brazilian Portuguese. So that's her native language.
Yeah.
So I thought that was really cool.
And it looked like just a couple up.
Yeah.
There was another the exact same set of languages.
Exactly.
Gabriel.
Yeah. So we've got the speakers. We kind of left it up to them to like you know choose their language that they're most comfortable with. A lot of them wanted to speak in English, but. You know, we're very open to,
yeah.
You know, to whatever.
It looks like Brazil is super well,
Brazilian is really well taken care of.
Yeah.
I think we had a couple also Italian, which, you know, I have no problem with whatsoever, being an Italian myself. Here's Russian, Russian and English. So that'll be, I think that'll be pretty interesting to have, like, folks, you know, opportunity to speak in other languages, let's put it that
for
way.
Sure.
So, yeah, and like we've got great speakers, as I said, so a lot of like really represented from the community and Microsoft. A lot of new speakers, I think, that were kind of, you'll see familiar faces, but you'll also see a lot of new speakers, I think, that are coming onto the team and want to talk about their products and what they're passionate about, so I'm all for it.
Right. Definitely. Yep. Looks like .NET Bot is super well represented.
Yeah, that's
well.
People who just don't want to give us pictures.
Yes.
Exactly. So.
Yeah. So one of the things I was telling you about before is, I just came back. I was just like an hour ago. I was mountain biking, and I was borrowing my friend's super new, you know, tripped out bike, and it was amazing to ride. And I was thinking to myself, wow, like you know, bike technology has changed a ton just in like a 2-year period.
Yeah.
And if I think about the stuff that we're working on, it has changed so much. Like even just like every 6 months, it seems like there's something really important to learn.
Absolutely.
And I'm thinking that .NET Conf is a great place to get started with that.
It is. It is really it's really like a deep technical training event. You know, it's about like you know showing you what's latest and new and hot and here's kind of the direction we're going and possible. But it also tries to be practical and show you sort of like, hey, here's how you can really dig in. Our community is great at really getting real world and practical. So it's nice to kind of have a bit of a balance. You always kind of want to know what the direction of like the ecosystem is going, but you also want to know like how do I actually do something that I care about?
Right.
So I think we have a lot. I mean, and .NET is such a broad platform. It's you know it's hard to choose. We had an open call for content. We had like 230 submissions or something like that, and it was really tough to choose. I mean, actually, we had our internal Microsoft people go out and do paper call and submit as well. So everybody was even right in there. Went through the same evaluation process.
Okay.
Yeah. And so, you know, it was really about like, wow, these are really good talks and who do we pick?
Mm-hmm.
So that was really hard. I mean, you only have 42 slots. So
yeah, and that number isn't changing.
225 was
yeah,
a lot. So we only had the call open for a month, and that was a lot of people submit. So that was really great to see. Actually.
That's a lot of excitement.
It was very exciting, super exciting. So
right. So what I kind of hear you saying is we've got talks for astronauts and talks for mechanics.
Yeah, exactly, and talks for me.
Yeah.
That I'm gonna understand. So it's been fun. It's a small agile team. We have a great time. I mean. Just the way we kind of pull together different expertise across like our little V team, but then we can immediately adjust. And we don't have to like it's literally a virtual conference though, right? I mean but we are trying to do local events, so we rely heavily on our ecosystem to pull this off, right?
Absolutely.
The V team is just here to kind of like get this thing running and promoted, and you know the content laid out, and then executing on it, right? But like really the sheer size of the number of the events are worldwide, that's what's really impressive to me. And obviously, you know, it's broadcasted, so if you can't find a local event, obviously you can watch it. But
totally.
That I think is kind of the coolest part of .NET Conf.
Well, you can't beat the price.
You can't beat the price. It's free. Right. Absolutely. Yeah. And we'll tune in right here, www.netconf.net. And we'll be syndicating across a couple other sites. Channel 9 will be broadcasting it on the homepage. We'll have it on the homepage, I think, of developermicrosoft.com running. So you'll be able to find it anywhere, hopefully.
Awesome. Okay. Well, I think... Yeah. People should be totally looking forward to this right now.
Absolutely,
right,
guys.
So what's the date again, just so we...
Yep, it kicks off September 12th at 8 a.m. Pacific time. So that's in 26 days, 16 hours, okay, and 17 minutes from this recording.
September the 12th.
September the 12th.
Okay, that's the one to look forward to. Okay, awesome. Well, this has been another episode of, I was going to say .NET Conf.
Yes.
On .NET Show with Beth, and we did learn, we got a sneak peek on .NET Conf. So, thanks for watching.
Tune in and save the date.
Yes, definitely.